As I'm sure you know, filmmaking is this complex art form that requires a collaboration among many specialists to create a production. However, some filmmakers want to take on multiple roles themselves, which sort of leads us to the question, is it better to be a jack of all trades or a specialist in filmmaking? All right, let's just dive right into the pro. So an immediate pro is if you are a jack of all trades, if you can do multiple things, you are immediately more valuable on a set. The more positions you know, the broader your understanding of filmmaking is, you're gonna be able to communicate more effectively to your entire crew, which is gonna eliminate so many problems. I went to school for cinematography. I crewed as every single position. I was a grip, electric, key grip, gaffer, BBG, BBE, camera PA, first AC, second AC, camera operator, and I was a cinematographer. I can easily communicate to them because I know what it's like to be in that position. That communication is invaluable. You'll save time, it'll help with creativity, and there's a deeper level of appreciation and respect among crew members. You should watch David Fincher's A Social Network behind the scenes documentary. It's incredible. He knows every single role and he knows exactly how you should do each role. There's a scene, I think, where there's boom shadow. After they cut, he's absolutely livid. He knows. It's like, we just lost that shot. And then another pro I would say is that it can save you money. So if you can do multiple jobs, then you can kind of cut back on how many people you need to hire to get the job done. This really works in the independent realm and super low budget music videos, small projects. So if I'm doing a really low budget music video where, let's just say it's $1,000, I can confidently go in there, direct it, shoot it, gaff it. I can pull my own focus. I can figure out the wardrobe, as opposed to me shelving out money for a cinematographer, money for a gaffer, a key grip. I've just lost, there's my whole budget right there, it's gone. Even just two people, it's gone. $1,000, it's nothing. But like, if I could do it all myself, then I just made $1,000. You know what I'm saying? So the fact that I took the time to learn these multiple skills, including editing, you can make more money. And when you first start out and you move out to Los Angeles or New York City and you're from a place like Tennessee or North Carolina where rent is like $300 instead of $1,500 or $2,000, I'll tell you, you'll learn multiple skills. You will learn multiple skills because you don't just always walk right in and have the budgets to be able to hire all the crew that you want to hire. If that happens for you, I love that. I love that that happened for you. But sometimes you get low budget productions and you kind of got to just do multiple roles in order to survive. It's not even a selfish thing of trying to make as much money as possible. It's like, oh, I literally haven't had a gig in a few weeks. I got this one gig and I can do the multiple roles. Yes, it's going to be more physically demanding. Yes, it's going to be more mentally demanding, but I can put up with that for a day and get that full $1,000 rate. Of course I can, and I will. Now, if I lacked skills, if I didn't have those skills, well, then I gotta hire someone. If I was a director and I got a $1,000 gig and I didn't know how to operate a camera or shoot and light it and et cetera, et cetera, well, then I would find a person that could do those multiple things. Be like, hey man, I got a $1,000 budget. I'll give you half, I'll give you 500, but you gotta be able to shoot it. You gotta be able to light it. You gotta be able to operate. You gotta do everything, okay? For low budget projects, you gotta think like that. You really do. This sort of perfectly leads into the cons of being a jack of all trades. So like the classic con that you always hear, the original quote that nobody ever finishes is, oh, jack of all trades, master of none. The rest of the quote goes, but oftentimes better than a master of one. It usually has a negative connotation that you're just someone that can do many different things, but you're not particularly good at one thing. I just don't believe that that is true. If you put enough time and energy into multiple skills and disciplines and you put the work in, you can master multiple things. You gotta have at least some other skill. For example, if you want to be a cinematographer and that's your specialty, okay, great. I get that you don't want to be producing the project, but even still, you're gonna have to learn some producing aspects. You're gonna have to learn budgeting. You're gonna have to understand equipment rental prices and insurance. You're still gonna need to know the other disciplines. Even editing. There are so many cinematographers that don't know how to edit, and you need to know how to edit. Editing is one of the most basic things to learn across all disciplines, especially if you're a cinematographer and you need to make a reel. You're telling me you can't make your own reel and you need to hire some editor and wait weeks and weeks and weeks when you could have just figured it out. You could have watched a YouTube video, a tutorial, learn how to edit to get your reel together, to get more work. That's ridiculous. I'll tell you that. That's ridiculous. You can learn how to edit. It's such a valuable skill. It's so valuable. It bleeds into all the other disciplines. You know, if you are a DP and you want to be a big DP, you know, you do need to learn heavily in that skill, but that goes for every discipline: producing, production design, sound design, directing, screenwriting, etc., etc. But that's the whole thing. Everyone's like, oh, if you spread yourself too thin, then you're not going to be highly masterful in that skill, and now you're going to lose out on career opportunities. I've never seen that happen. I haven't been involved in that. I can't speak for that. But what I can speak for is being a jack of all trades on these productions, doing multiple roles. A con is that it is physically and mentally demanding, and that's just bottom line. That 100% you will come across that, and a lot of people can't handle it. And if you're doing multiple roles back to back to back to back, I mean, you could burn out like that, seriously. Another thing that can happen is that you might be on set, you're doing like three or four roles, now you're making mistakes, and that could be dangerous. You forgot shots, you forgot to format the memory card, or you formatted the memory card that you were already shooting with. There's definitely mistakes that can happen. You have to make checklists, and you have to be prepared to just handle the multiple roles. My advice is finding a teammate, a partner, someone that is also doing multiple roles, and you can sort of balance each other. I'm gonna be directing, I'm gonna be the cinematographer, I'm gonna light this. Those are three things, and they're all in production, they're all in the same realm, they're all pushing for the vision. If you can handle the craft services, how to park, where the locations are, the insurance, you're gonna save so much time, and you're gonna save my life. That's how you should be thinking. Remember, I'm speaking on the low budget realm for all this stuff. If I had a budget for everything, you bet I'm gonna be getting every position that I can. So in conclusion to this video, there are pros and there are cons to being a jack of all trades. It can make you more valuable on set, you can save money, but you can also burn yourself out, you can cause mistakes, you could potentially not be so skilled in a discipline that you aren't going to the next level. Ultimately, whether you choose to be a specialist or jack of all trades depends on your personal preferences, your skill set, and your career goals. I think it's just important to find a balance that's going to allow you to excel in your craft, but while also being versatile and adaptable in this fast-paced world of filmmaking. Thank you for watching this video. I hope this helped you understand a little bit more about the pros and cons of being a jack of all trades. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I will see you next time.